Welcome to another edition of the Arch Rival Roller Girls Rewind alongside Miguel Gorilla. My name's Muckety Muck. We're recapping the action here on Mother's Day weekend here at Midwest Sport Hockey. No coast in town. Another doubleheader night of derby, and a fun night it was.
It was a great night. A dominant effort from Arch Rival, but most importantly, I think what we saw tonight, not just the wins, this league is learning and growing now. These two teams that we saw tonight are getting better.
And I want to give a quick disclaimer before you see the highlights. You fans are going to enjoy the cinematography that you're going to see here tonight. I tried to simultaneously call about and shoot footage. I mean, look at this spectacular stuff. I picture and envision Emmys coming to this broadcast soon here, Gorilla.
No.
I understand completely. We did the best that we could considering the circumstances that we were facing, the resources that we had, but the resources were aplenty for the arch rival All-Stars, number 21 in the WFTDA, taking on No Coast, the number 31 team in the WFTDA. We knew if arch rival was going to keep that home streak going here at Midwest Sport Hockey, they would have to bring their A game. They did tonight.
Yeah, No Coast beat them last year. People forget about that. Last jam, 3 points, shocked the world a little bit. But arch rival was looking for revenge, and we're going to see that they didn't wait long to take advantage.
Let's take a look at first half action. Arch rival actually behind the eight ball early as No Coast got out to a quick lead, but then arch rival rolled up a 53-0 rally thanks in part to this. A 30-point power jam scored by Brickyard with about 6 minutes deep into this bout stretched open a huge differential in this contest.
I feel like a broken record, another 100-plus point game from Brickyard. She is just dominant when she's on the track. She takes care of business. Nobody can come close to her when she's out there.
And we saw arch rivals stretch their lead to 111-44 at intermission. Thanks in part to this, we're actually going to focus on the blocking. Everything looking really solid for the arch rival walls this evening, paced by Eli Wallop, Mayor Francis Slayer, a host of others. The blocking really stretched this game wide open.
It really did. And actually, we're going to talk about this later with Brickyard. You might see have a clip on it. They were trying some new stuff tonight with arch rival. And I tell you what, it was really effective.
Arch rival kept that momentum going in the second period, about 6 minutes deep into this one. Another huge roll of points. Mighty Mighty Boston with an 18-point power jam put this one in the winning column of the locals.
Just a great bookend with Brickyard. The two of them are a 1-2 punch that's really hard to deal with. Not to say that the rest of the jammers are a problem for arch rival, but those two are just a real handle.
Arch rival outscores No Coast 137-94 in the second half. Number 21 internationally, they're winners with the 248-138 victory over the Mad Maxines. Big output from Brickyard, as we said. Let's hear from her.
I will say that on Monday we introduced about 10 different things for us to work on, and we did a lot of that tonight, which is very surprising. And I think we're getting much more confident working together as a team. So I think we all were super excited about how things ended up tonight, even though we did have some rough play here and there.
The co-captain said it herself. New strategies being implemented by arch rival. They're looking really solid as a team right now.
Well, it's going to be a big run now. We're going to see a lot of road games from this team against some really, really challenging opponents. And I think what they were thinking about tonight was, let's try some stuff out on a team that we feel that we can beat if we play our game, and if we can play these new strategies, we can even get ourselves even better for the future.
With the victory, arch rival, the A squad improves to 3-1 on the campaign. A lot of tough derby. We'll talk about that here in just a little bit. And also trending up were the St. Lunatics. They were coming in after a very impressive victory over Cincinnati a couple of weeks ago, and they had a very tough contest against No Coast, but just like we saw in our A bout, blocking really playing a big key in what turned out to be a pretty sizable win here for the Lunatics.
Yeah, we're talking about a team that's growing. We talked about it all season long. We saw these improvements against a loss against Madison, a squad that we now are looking at as a league is so strong, but they got even better, did the Lunatics tonight. And we'll see it here in the video.
Just like we saw in the A bout, the B squad from No Coast coming out to the early lead, but then arch rival turned it around. The Lunatics scoring 14 off of this power jam from Enya Nightmare. 5 minutes deep into this bout, arch rival up by 5.
You know, we talked about Nightmare and everybody else being so even. All the jammers, we had 4 jammers score over 50 points. The points were distributed across the board from the Lunatics.
Continuing on with first period action, Molecular Mayhem back into the mix scoring-wise, thanks to her system doing the blocking up front. This 12-pointer accumulated, and it stretched the lead to 70-36.
What was so neat about the blocking tonight is not only were they opening up holes in the initial part of the jam, but in the second part of the jam, in the first scoring pass, they were opening up huge lanes for these jammers to go through. Really nice to see.
Loon shakes up 107-51 at intermission. Second period action now, and the momentum kept rolling on. Sleazy E for the Lunatics, scoring 15 on this strike right here. Once again, arch rival using that blocking up front, really stretching wide the differential.
The blockers for arch rival had only given up 3 points in the first 10 minutes of the second half. Pretty dominant stuff.
Lunatics outscore No Coast 130-34 in the second period of play. They roll on and improve to 2-2 with the 237-85 victory over the Road Warriors from No Coast. Ginger Assassin, she was the MVP blocker. Let's listen to her comments.
I feel like with every bout, we've been getting better each time. We're taking the things that we don't do well and working on those, and taking things that we are doing well and continuing to work on those so that we're better. So each time we are better.
I tell you what, whether it was MVP blocker or jammer being awarded tonight, that was going to be a pretty tough call there. I mean, everybody well deserving of an award here tonight.
Yeah, it was hard to find like a special person just to point to that did a great job, because there's so many names we called all night long. Jamming and blocking, it was a team effort. It's a team sport, and they executed across the board.
And the execution is going to have to be at an all-time high for both these squads coming up in late May. We've got a lot of activity. You're not going to see any here at Midwest Sport Hockey for a while, unfortunately, but we do have some big-time matchups coming up for both these squads. Let's look at the lineup here for the arch-rival All-Stars at Midwest Brouhaha in Milwaukee in the final weekend of May. On a Friday night, they got number 10 Minnesota. On a Saturday night, they got number 13 Naptown. How about those apples for your selections there at Brouhaha?
These are tough squads. Arch-rival knows these teams very well. They've actually beaten them both in the last few years. They've lost to them both as well. It's going to be interesting to see what happens on a neutral site. But this is a league that has trying new things tonight. We talked about it. They're going to try to do it again when they play after this has taken place. And we'll see if they can bring it to Brouhaha.
Yeah, and Brouhaha will be live online via WFTDA.TV Presents. So check your schedule for when those bouts are taking place. Then continuing on, they've got a busy, busy June. And let's start out with what's going to be an intriguing bout, where they will be facing number 15 Atlanta. That's coming up on June 14th. Well, you know, by the time the rankings come out, the next wave, our numbers might be different. But Atlanta, once again, a top 20 squad, and they are surging up.
A squad I don't know very well, frankly. I'm looking forward to watching them between now and then to see what arch rival is going to be going up against. This is a team that if you beat, you could really do some damage in the rankings by moving up.
And then an epic weekend, the final weekend of June. Take a look at this trio of bouts coming up for the All-Stars. Friday night, June 27th, arch rival battles the defending WFTDA Division II champions, Jet City. That might be the only time Jet City ever wins a D2 title, because they're just that doggone good right now. That's on a Friday night. Then on Saturday night, Rose City, top five team right now. And of course, that's going to be a solid matchup. And then we've got the Ole Rollers on a Sunday hangover bout on June the 29th. So Jet City, Rose City, and Ole, that's a big trio of bouts right there. And we're going to find out just how tough this squad is, because there's no easy predictions on any of those.
Mamma mia, I'm sweating thinking about that one right now. I tell you, it's going to be tough. Folks that remember our driver from last year, they played Rose City in the postseason. I think Rose City's better this year than last year, and our rival lost to them. That's a scary, scary squad out there.
And then, of course, the Ole Rollers, the defending USARS championships, and we're still kind of trying to gauge what Ole is all about this season. They got roughed up a little bit at the Big O a couple of weeks ago, but that's still a very powerful opponent.
It really is, and they're gonna bring a lot of athleticism, a lot of talent. If they really clean up their penalties and get used to the new style that they're not used to playing, they're going to be really dangerous. And let's not forget, Rose City is coached by someone St. Louis fans might know. Former St. Louis Gatekeeper men's team, Jukebox Heroes out there.
And I tell you what, from what I've heard from the Rose City folks, they've loved that guy out there. And we loved him, too. We wish he was back the fold here. A lot of action for the All-Stars and, of course, the St. Lunatics. Want to find out more about it? Check out the official website. You can visit our Facebook page, or you can visit us via the tweet at ARRG. That's going to be a strong trio of bouts. And arch rival has beaten the odds in the past and even this season. We're going to get to see what this team is really made of here in June.
They're in a great position right now. They can get better, and they can really improve their position for the postseason. After June 30th, it's going to be over for that perspective, and we're going to know where they're going to be ranked, and we're going to know where the playoffs are going to be. It's going to be an amazing month and a half to get there.
That's Miguel Aguirre. I'm Muckety Muck. Thanks so much for watching The Rewind.